Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. This is our second lecture on Class 8, Chapter 2, Exercise 2.4. In our first lecture, what we were discussed, we take its examples and get questions from question number 1 to question number 5. So this is our second lecture. Now we have to take its next remaining question. That's why I am taking this next question. Question number is 6. Before to start the video, I request to everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end. If you like my video, then please do like and do subscribe, as well as to share it with your friends, so everyone gets the benefit of this video. So come on, our first question. Please read the statement very carefully and try to find out what the statement actually wants to ask us. Please make a read. There is a narrow rectangular plot. It means we have a rectangular plot, and all the things related to the rectangular, you keep it in your minds. Watch it. This is your rectangular plot. Because rectangular plot has a length as well as breadth. So this is length, this is breadth. The opposite sides are equal. So this is length. This is breadth and this is breadth. Now read the statement next. Reserved for a school. It means this is a rectangular plot and reserved for a garden in your school. In Mohali, Mohali means there is a village in Mohali. The length and the breadth of the plots are in the ratio. Again, the question based on the ratio. And you know what we have to do? We have to take its length and breadth. We have to assume. And what will we do? Now, we have to assume what's the length and the breadth. Length is, ratio is 11:4. It means length becomes 11x and breadth is 4x, because the ratio are given. So we have to suppose by taking multiplication with x. So these are the ratio of length and breadth. That's why I am taking the length is 11x and breadth is taken as 4x. Now read the next statement. At a rate 100 rupees per meter, it will cost the village. Means the village panchayat have to pay 75,000 rupees at a cost of 100 rupees per meter to fence. Fence means we have to use protection wire at the outer edge of the plot. Again, please read. Fence means we have to cover the boundary of the plot with a protecting wire. That is called a fence. So fence is, but where we have to put on the fence? We have to put the fence on the boundary. On the boundary. It means we have to use the fence. This is fence. We have put outside of the boundary of the plot. Then what will be the total length of the fence required? Total length of the fence. You know, we have to use this fence on the boundary. So we have to add the boundaries, and what is the total length of the boundary is its perimeter. Because if we start from here, we have to cover first this length, then we have to cover this breadth, then we have to cover this length, then we have to cover this breadth. It means we have to take the fence throughout the boundary, and boundary is called the perimeter of the rectangular plot. So total length of the fence is equal to perimeter of rectangular plot. And we know what's the perimeter? Twice of length plus breadth, which is equal to 2 multiply length plus breadth. And we know what's the length is? Length is 11x and breadth is 4x. Now put it here. 2 into length is 11x plus breadth is 4x. Now solve this. 2 multiply 11 plus 11x plus 4x, which is equal to 15x. Now multiply 2 into 15, which is 30 into x. We get 30x. This is what? This is total length of fence is 30x. Now please make a read here. The cost of fencing is 100 rupees per meter square. It means the length of 1 meter fencing is 100 rupees. Then what will be the total cost of the length? The total length is 30x. I am taking an example. If an apple, one apple comes at a rate of 5 rupees per apple. I am again repeat the statement. The cost of one apple is 5 rupees. Then what will be the total cost of the 10 apple? Naturally, 5 into 10, which is equal to 50. So this indicates that cost of 100 rupees per meter, it means the cost of 1 meter length of fencing. Here, cost of 1 meter length of fencing is 100 rupees. Then what will be the total cost? The length is, total length is what? 30x, and the cost of length 1 meter is 100. So total cost is 100 multiply 30x. So total cost of fencing, which is equal to cost of fencing per meter, means the cost of length of 1 meter, multiply by total length of fencing, total length of the fencing. So please make a note first, then we will do our next part. Please make a read. Firstly, you have to write this, then we have to write this. After that, you will write from here. Total cost of fencing, which is equal to cost of fencing for 1 meter. Multiply, it means cost of one apple is this, and we have to multiply the number of apple. Number of apple means the total length of the fencing. I hope this concept will be clear to you. Again, I repeat the concept. Please make a look here. If this 1 meter length cost is 100 rupees. This is 1 meter length. Now, if we require this length, which is 5 meter, then what will be the cost? 1 meter cost is 100 rupees and the total length is 5 meter. So, total cost is 5 into 100, which is equal to 500 rupees. This is the basic concept. Now same here, we have to find total cost. It means cost of fencing of 1 meter, which is here in this case 100 rupees. So that's why I am taking here 100 Now we have to multiply the length of the fencing. In this case, the total length is perimeter of the rectangle, because the wire we have to use for fencing is put on the rectangular plot. It means we have to cover the whole boundary of the rectangle. So we require the total length is perimeter of the rectangular plot. So this is the our total length, and what's the total length is 30x. So I am multiplying here 30x. So this becomes the total cost of the fencing. So I am rubbing this portion. Now the total cost of fencing is already given in the statement. Please make a read. Will cost the village 75,000. It means we already know the total cost. But the total cost is 75,000 rupees. So I am putting here, because this is total cost of the fencing, we know 75,000. Now we have to solve this and find. Here suppose this is 30 into x. I am writing here only 30x. So this becomes the equation for the question. Now we have to solve for the x. Now what we have to do? Firstly, we have to multiply it. 100 into 30, we got 3000, and x term as it is, which is equal to 75,000. Now we have to calculate x, so that's why I have to take in the denominator part 75,000 divided by 3000. Now 30 will be cancelled out with 30. Now cut 3 ones are 3, and if we cut, we find 25 upon 1. It means we get x is equal to 25. This is the values for the x, but not the answer. But we have to calculate what are the dimension. Dimension means we have to calculate the length and the breadth. And we know what's the length is 11x. So our answer is length is 11x, and we know what's the value of x is 25. So 11 into 25, which is equal to 275. Now what is the breadth? 4 into x. Breadth is 4x, which is equal to 4 into 25, which is equal to 100 meter. This is our final answer. So you have to note it. Please make a note step by step. Firstly, you have to write this, then you have to write from this portion, and then final is from here. So keep it in mind, you have to write in step by step. First step, second step, and third step. According to these steps, you have to note in your fair notebook. Now be ready for our next question. Please make a read the statement. Statement is very, very good. So this question is very lengthy and very complex, very tough. So we have to do one by one step and keep all the points very sharply. If you learn and read all the statement very, very carefully, then you can do this question. Otherwise, this question becomes very difficult. So please make a look very carefully. Hassan buys two kinds of cloth. Hassan is a person, and he buys some cloth for school uniform. It means Hassan have to prepare a uniform, and for uniform he required a cloth. So what type of cloth he required? He required two type of cloth: shirt material, and that cost 50 rupees per meter, and trouser material that cost rupees 90 rupees per meter. Again I repeat the concept and read the statement. Hassan had to prepare a uniform, and for uniform I am drawing here the figure so you can get the basic and clear idea about the question statement. Which Hassan have to prepare a uniform dress? He has to prepare uniform dress, and for uniform dress, you know, the cloth material or cloth type of cloth that is basic required to make a uniform cloth. What type of cloth? He required two type of cloth to make a uniform set. So required one is trouser cloth, second required shirt cloth. It means for preparing a one uniform set, he has to require two type of clothes, one trouser cloth and second is shirt. After that, both of these cloth to make a uniform. And in this shirt material, that cost rupees 50 per meter. It means what it say? It say the cost of shirt cloth is 50 rupees per meter. It means if the length, the cost of 1 meter length of cloth is 50 rupees. If he require 2 meter, then what he have to pay? 2 into 50, which is 100. If he require 3 meter, then what he have to pay? 3 into 50, 150 rupees. So please make a note here. This is the cost of 1 meter length. Now, cost of 1 meter, cost of 1 meter length of trouser is 90 rupees per meter. Means this is 90 rupees per meter. Means the cost of 1 meter length of trouser is 90 rupees and the cost of shirt material is 50 rupees per meter. Now please read the next part of the statement. He sells the material. It means he sells the material, trouser and he, cloth, at a 10% and 12% profit. It means he sells this type of cloth at 12% and 10% profit. But in this portion, we don't know the selling price of the trouser and the selling price of the shirt material. But we have given the, but we have given only the profit. It means here profit. What's profit? Profit firstly is shirt material. It means the first is your shirt material profit, and shirt material profit is 12%, and then 10% profit. Second material is trouser. It means the profit on trouser cloth is 10%. So here profit is 10%. Now another is his total sales. Total sales. We know total sales is, what's the total sales is? 36. Please make a note here. 36600 rupees. Total sales. Total sales is the sales of trouser cloth plus sales of sales price of trouser. So total sales means selling price of trouser plus selling price of shirt. Total selling price means selling price of cloth, shirt plus selling price of trouser cloth. This is when we combine, we get the total selling price. So this is our total selling price. and we know the total selling price, we know, but we don't know that what's the selling price of the trouser and what's the selling price of the shirt. So please make a note first and make a clear view, and please read the statement at least 2 minutes. I hope you will read the statement again. Hassan buy 2 kinds of cloth, we know, trouser cloth and shirt material. The cost of trouser cloth is 90 rupees per meter and shirt material cost is 50 rupees per meter. If we sell the trouser, he got a profit of 10%, and for shirt he get a profit of 12%, and the total selling price is his 36,600 rupees. And we know total selling means selling of trouser clothes plus selling price of shirt materials. So we have to first calculate the total selling price of the shirt materials and total selling price of the shirt cloth. Then we add them, we get the total selling price, and we know the total selling price. So first we have to calculate the selling price of the trouser. So first we have to calculate the cost price. In this we know the cost price of 1 meter, but don't know what's the length of the trouser material required and what's the length of the shirt material required. Please make a read again the statement. Please here, for every 2 meter of trouser he buy 3 meter of shirt material. It means we are given ratio trouser cloth and shirt cloth in the ratio of 2:3. So again we have to do let trouser cost, trouser length is 2x and shirt length is 3x. So we get, I'm writing here, trouser length is 2x and shirt length is 3x, and we have to calculate the how much trouser material we have to find out. So please make a note first, then I will rub this upper portion and write it in a simple step, then you can write in your fair notebook. Please again I repeat the statement. Hassan buys two kinds, he wants to prepare a uniform, false uniform. He have for making a uniform, he has to be required a shirt cloth as well as trouser cloth. For trouser cloth, the cost of 1 meter trouser cost is 90 rupees and the cost of 1 length meter of the shirt material is 50 rupees. And if we sell them, he get a profit on shirt is 12% and profit on trouser is 10%. And if we make a uniform, then the total selling price that he obtained, which is equal to 36,600 rupees. So but in this we know total selling price means total selling price of the shirt materials plus my total selling price of the trouser. So if we add them, we get the total selling price, but in this we don't know the selling price. So firstly we have to calculate the cost price, and we use a formula for the selling price. After that we can solve this. So please again read the statement, and here there is no need to note down because I am again writing this here. Please read the statement again 2 times. So please make a note, I have the whole portion, and write again the statement very short. For school uniform set, he required trouser cloth and shirt cloth. Cost of 1 meter length is 90 rupees and cost of 1 meter length of shirt material is 50 rupees. Profit is 10%, profit is 12%. Firstly, we have to calculate the cost price. And please take a brief cost price and selling price and profit. Suppose this marker. If I am going in a markets and purchase a marker, the cost of marker is 25 rupees. It means cost price of marker is 25 rupees, and I sell to further my friend with a rupees of 30 rupees. So I sell it ₹30. I purchase from the market ₹25, but I sell to my friend is ₹30, and naturally I get a profit. What's the profit is? Selling price. This is selling price. Selling price minus cost price. So selling price is 30, cost price is 25. I got 5 rupees. So this is our profit. So there is a relation between cost price, selling price and profit. You have to learn it. What's the relation is? Relation between SP, I am writing the full form, selling price cost price and profit is selling price is 100 plus profit divided by 100 into cost price. Please note it, the cost sale price is equal to 100 plus profit divided by 100 into cost price. In this question we have to use this to find the selling price. So by this example, to make a note in separate page after the end of the question, you have to note in your fair notebook. That's why this question will be remember in every time when I'm giving a test or you have to prepare for your exam. Please make a note first. Now please make a note. So trouser and this is shirt, and again the statement part given us 2 meter of trouser material required 3 meter of shirt material. It means we are given the ratio, that's why we have to take let. What we have to take let? Let trouser cloth is 2 meter, so we have to let 2 into x then shirt cloth which is 3x. Now we have to find out the selling price. Firstly we have to calculate the cost price. This is the total length of the required of the trouser material and the shirt material, and we know cost of the 1 meter trouser is 90 and the cost of the shirt material is 50 rupees, and this is the length. Again, if 1 meter length of shirt is 50 rupees and I require 5 meter, then how we calculate 5 into 50? Same here, trouser cloth is the length. Here you have to use length of the trouser cloth is 2x. So total cost is length multiply price. Length is 2x and price is what? 90. We get 180x, and for this total cost Total cost for shirt. Length is this and price is 50 rupees. So we have to do 3x multiply 50. We get 150x. This is nothing. This is basically cost price. This is your CP, cost price. Now we have to calculate the selling price, and we know the first formula for the selling price is selling price is 100 plus profit divided by 100 into cost price. We know this right here. We know now selling price of trouser 100 plus profit. Profit is 10 divided by 100 into cost price. Cost price is what? Trouser cost price is 180x. Now solve this. 100 plus 10, which is equal to 110 divided by 100 into 180. Now 0 will cancel out with 0 and 0 will cancel out with this 0. But we will get 18 into 11, we get 198x. Similar selling price of shirt 100 plus profit. Profit is what? 12% divided by 100 into cost price, and shirt cost price is 150x. So I am writing here 150x. Now solve this. 100 plus 12, 112 divided by 100 into 150. Now cut it. 0 will cancel out with 0. 5 threes are 15. 5 twos are 10. Now cut it. 2 ones are 2. And if we cut, we get 56. Now multiply 56 into 3. We get 168x. This is the selling price of both. Now we have used total selling price. Please make a note, then I rub this portion. Now I am solving here total selling price. Selling price of what? Trouser and clothes. So selling price of trouser plus selling price of shirt. We know total selling price is what? Given 36,600 rupees. And selling price of trouser is what? Selling price of trouser is 198x plus selling price of shirt is 168x. Now solve it. What we will got? We got 366x, which is equal to 3660. Now we have to calculate for x, divide by 360 to the left hand side. But we will got 3660 divided by 366. It cut into 100. If you divide, you get 100. It means the values of x is 100. Our answer is not 100. We have to calculate the length of the trouser. And what's the length of the trouser is? Length of the trouser is 2x. So our length of trouser is 2 into x, which is 2 into 100. We get 200 answer. Please make a note. So previous question was very tough, and you need to do more practice. If you do more and more practice, then previous question you will be get out very quickly. Otherwise that question becomes very tough. So you have to require more practice on such type of question. Now I am going to take our next question. What's the question is? Half of the herd of the deers. It means there are number of deers are grazing in the field. It means we have an area was this is the field where the a group of deers are moving. Some of them are half of the deers are grazing. It means someone deers are grazing. And the remaining are playing. It means someone are playing. And the rest are drinking. This is number of deers. Pacemaker not here. In a field, there is so many number of deers. And some of deers are drinking water, some of deers are playing, and some of deers are grazing the fields. But we don't know how many number of deers. So this is a question, we have to find out the number of deers. We don't know. So we have to do assume. Let number of deers, let numbers of deers is x. We have x number of deers that are present in the field. Now please read the statement. Half of the deers are grazing. Half. If there are 10 deers in the field and half are grazing, half means what's the half of 10 is 10 by 2, which is equal to 5. It means we have to divide it by 2. We get the half of the deers. Again, please make a note. If there are 10 numbers of deers in the field and half of the deers are grazing, what's the half of 10? Divide by 2, we get 5. And what's the another 5? Which is this? Means we are dividing 10 into 2 parts, which is called half. So what's the half is 10 by 2. It means we have, if we divide by 2, we get half. So same here. Here the number of deers is x, but here the number of deers are 10. What we do? We divide by 2 and get the half the number of deers. Now half of the deers means 10 by 2, x by 2 are grazing. Now, if half of the deers are grazing, then half what we have remaining? Again, we have get 5. Go there. Please see, if we have 10 and we divide into 2 parts, which is equal to half. So this is 5 and this is 5. If these are grazing, then remaining is what? Is again 5. So the remaining is here. I am writing here. Now remaining deers is x by 2. I hope you clear this concept. So 10, what's the half is 5 and 5. So 5 are grazing and 5 are the remaining. Now what we have to do in our next part? Now read. 3/4 means 3 by 4 of the remaining. What's the remaining is? X by 2. So read the statement. 3 by 4 of remaining. Of remaining. And what's the remaining is? X by 2. So we write here 3 by 4 multiply x by 2, because the remaining is x by 2. Now solve this. We know numerator is multiplied with numerator and denominator is multiplied with denominator. So 3 into x, we get 3x. 4 into 2, we get 8. So we get 3x by 8. These deers are what? Are playing. So these deers are playing. playing. So these deers are grazing and these deers are playing. And read again. Rest 9 deers are drinking. So number of deers drinking water is 9. I hope you clear this concept. Half of the deers are grazing and 3/4 of the remaining are playing and rest 9 are drinking. Now what we will call? If we add them, we get the total number of deers. So please make a note first. I hope this concept will be clear to you, because I am drawing this diagram. Some of the deers are grazing. What's the grazing, sir? X/2. And number of deers are playing. What's the 3x/8? These deers are playing. And 9 deers are what? Drinking water. We add them, we get the total number of deers. So please make a note first. Firstly, you have to draw a diagram. Then you have to write in terms of 3 columns. Please make a note. Now I am writing total number of deers is equal to what? Number of deers are grazing plus number of deers that are playing plus number of deers that are drinking water. And we know total number of the deers, we assume first, which is equal to S. So this is your X. Now number of deers are grazing is X/2. So we got X/2 plus number of deers are playing, which is equal to 3x/8. I am writing here 3x/8 plus number of deers are drinking water, which is equal to 9. Now this is our equation. We have to solve it and get the value of X. So please make a note first. Now we have to solve this. So firstly we have to take separate X. Now this is X term as it is. Now if we move on left hand side, the sign of this becomes negative X/2. If we take this 3x/4, it on the left hand side, we get another 3x/8. And here we got only 9. Now we have to solve this. Here all the terms are numerator and denominator terms. So I am writing divide by 1. Because we divide by 1, we get the answer is same. Now we have to take the LCM of 2 and 4. What's the LCM of 2 and 4 is 8. We get 8. Now if we divide by 1, we get 8. 8 into x, we get 8x. 2 4s are 8. So 4 into x, 4x. 8 1s are 8. 1. 1 into 3x minus 3x, which is equal to 9. Now solve this. 8x minus 4x minus 3x, which is minus 7x. Divide by 8, which is equal to 9. 8x minus 7x, x divided by 8, which is equal to 9. And we know, if we can also write as divide by 1, now do cross multiplication. 1 into x, we get x. 9 multiply 8, we get 72. So this is our answer. 72 is number of the deers. So please make a note. Now please read the next statement of our question. A grandfather is 10 times older than his granddaughter. If we don't know the granddaughter is, then how is it possible to calculate the age of his grandfather? So we have to do assume the granddaughter is. Granddaughter is X years. Now what's the age of granddaughter? Then grandfather age is what? 10 times means 10 multiply x, 10x here. Grandfather age is 10 times the age of his granddaughter. I hope you understand this. Now read next. He is means granddaughter. According to question, he means grandfather is 54 years. Grandfather is 54 years older than her. This means 54 plus the age of his granddaughter. Again, I repeat the concept. You know, the granddaughter has high age or large age as compared to his granddaughter. But according to granddaughter, father is 10 times older as granddaughter. I am assume granddaughter is x. Then what will be the grandfather is 10 times 10 into x, we get 10x. Now according to question, he is means grandfather. Grandfather is 54 years plus his and her. Her means granddaughter. So I write granddaughter. Now what's the age of grandfather is 10x plus 54. And what's the age of granddaughter is x. This is our equation we have to solve. Now move this x on the left hand side. We get negative x because here the sign is positive. Here sign is 54. 10x minus 1x, we get 9x. 9x is equal to 54. And we have to calculate x. So we have to move 9 on the right hand side. So we move 9 on the right hand side. 54 by 9, we get 6. So x is 6. We have to calculate their present age. Present age is this. Present age of granddaughter. Granddaughter age is x. And what's the value of x is 6. First answer. Now grandfather age is 10x. Means 10 into x. So 10 into 6, which is 16 years. So our answer is granddaughter age is 6 years and grandfather age is 60 years. So please make a note. Our next question is what? Please make a read the statement. Aman age is 3 times his son age. Again, we don't know the age of son, then how is possible to calculate the Aman age? So we have to do assume. What's the age of his son? Then we calculate the age of his Aman. Let age of his son, which is x year, then what will be the age of Aman? Then age of Aman is what? Aman age is 3 times. 3 times, 3 multiply. His son name and the age of son is x. It means we get 3x. Now read 10 years ago. It means I am assuming present age. Present age of his son is x and present age of the Aman is 3x. Now I am talking 10 years ago. If suppose my age is today is 30 years, then what was the age in 10 years ago? 30 minus 10, 20. So we have to do subtract 10. 10 years ago, age of his son. Today is x. Before 10 years is x minus 10. days of a month. Current days or present days is 3x. Now 10 years before is 3x minus 10. Now read. 10 years ago he means Aman. So according to question, what it state? He was means Aman is 5 times his son age. Again read the statement. 10 years ago he means Aman is 5 times means 5 multiply his son age. Son age, and we know all this. What's the Aman age is 3x minus 10. And what is the son age is x minus 10. Now we have to solve and get the answer. This is 3x minus 10. Now do 5 into x, we get 5x. 5 into 10, 50. Now we have to solve it. Now take it. Now move this 3x on the right hand side. Here as it is, I am writing 5x as it is. And moving 3x on the right hand side, then the sign of 3x becomes negative. We get minus 3x. Here is minus 10. And moving minus 50 on the left side, the sign of minus 50 becomes positive 50. Minus 10 plus 50, we get 40 is equal to 5x minus 3x, which is 2x. Now what will be the values of x? Divide by 2. 40 divided by 2, we get x is equal to 20. Now we have to calculate their present age. Our answer is present age. First, son. Present age of his son is x. And what's the values of x is 20. It means we get 20 years. Now we have to calculate Aman. What's the age of Aman is 3x. It means what's the values of x is 20. So we get 60 here, because the son age is x. So I am writing here x. What's the values of x is 20. Now Aman age is 3x. And x value is 20, so 3 into 20 we get 60 years. Please make a note. I hope this will be clear to you. If you like my video, if you really like my video, so please do subscribe and comment if you want some more in the video. And don't forget to subscribe and to share with your friends. Then I will make a next video and we will meet very soon. Thank you once again for watching my video from start to end. Again I repeat, Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes, don't forget to subscribe. Please make a note.